Sorry about that awkward transition, but hopefully you have followed us along from our previous Station Setup and App Connection Part 1 video that contained all of the steps to get your station connected to the internet. In this video, we will pick up right where that one left off by first highlighting the changes you'll see on your station screen once connected, and then walk you through the setup pages for how your outdoor sensor information will be brought into the Crosse View app. So, let's get started. In the last video, we connected your station to the internet. Upon doing so, you should have noticed some changes on its LCD screen. First, your time and date information should have automatically been updated. Second, your Wi-Fi indicator icon should have gone from flashing to solid on screen. And third, depending on the model you have, you should see a difference in the amount and type of forecast information displayed. Keep in mind, these changes simply indicate that your station is connected to the internet, and may take up to 15 minutes to take effect. In the previous video, we left off on this app screen, which is what you'll see when your station successfully connects to your Wi-Fi network. But after you do see this success dialog box appear, simply select OK. The screen that appears next is important to understand, as it describes the process for how your station's sensors will be brought into the Crosse View app. Basically, as long as you're running the latest version of our app, and your sensor's data is appearing on your in-home display, these will automatically be added into your Crosse View account through your notification center. So, after pressing Done on this page, the app will bring you to your home screen, which should be displaying your station's indoor data. Within the next 15 minutes, your notification center's cloud should turn red and show a number for the amount of outdoor sensors connected on your station. When your notifications appear, tap this icon to continue. The following Notifications page will list each of your connected sensors. Press their Add buttons to sync them to your app. An Add Device page will come up next. Here you'll have to give the sensor a device name and select a location for it to be assigned to. You can learn more about device and location names in our following support videos, but for now, select Done to officially add the sensor to your Crosse View app. If you have multiple sensors, follow this process by pressing their Add buttons as well. Once all of your sensors have been added, select Done in the upper corner to go back to your home screen. Here, you should now be able to swipe left and right to see each of your individual device pages. We will go more in depth on how this all works in the next video. So, congratulations! You have just gone through the hardest part of setting up and using your new weather station. And now that you're connected, you're free to enjoy all of the benefits the Crosse View app has to offer. Please follow us along in our next video, where we show you just how easy the app is to navigate. We'll cover how to find device information and introduce you to the app's most useful features. But once again, welcome to the Crosse Technology family. We're glad you're here.